Hey everybody, it's Professor Williams, and we're going to look in this video at z-scores and determine what exactly is a z-score. So by definition, a z-score, sometimes referred to as a standard score, simply represents the number of standard deviations that an individual value of x falls either above or below the mean when we have normal bell-shaped or symmetrical distribution. In other words, it simply takes the distance from x to the mean and converts it to units of standard deviation. Because the formula for a z-score is simply the distance that x falls from the mean, and then we take that distance and we divide it by the value of the standard deviation, and that gives us our z-score in units of standard deviation. So for illustrative purposes, let's say that we have a distribution that has a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 10. If I have a value of x that's 90, I'm simply going to take that 90 minus my mean of 100. I'm going to divide it by my standard deviation of 10, and that's going to give me a z-score of negative 1. So now I know my value of x falls here, which is one standard deviation below the mean. Same way, if I have an x value equal to 110, then when I find my z-score, I simply take my 110 minus the mean of 100. I divide that up into units of standard deviation, and now I know this one has a z-score of a positive 1, or that value of x would fall one standard deviation above the mean. It's helpful to think of this normal curve in terms of these standard deviations, number of standard deviations that run parallel to the horizontal axis. Remember that since normal curves are asymptotic and run to positive and negative infinity, there's any one of an infinite possible values for your z-scores, both on the positive and the negative end. The other thing is, remember that since this is a continuous distribution, your z-scores can be anywhere along this line and take on any one of an infinite number of values. So it's helpful to remember that values of x that fall to the right or above the mean will have positive z-scores, and values of x that fall to the left or below the mean will have negative z-scores. As always, I hope you found this video useful, and thanks so much for watching.